This is a big one. The second largest Oracle has ever done, behind PeopleSoft some 11 years ago. This is $9.3 billion to PeopleSoft's $10.3. But unlike PeopleSoft, this is anything but a hostile takeover. Oracle founder and executive chairman Larry Ellison also co-founded NetSuite, and he and entities connected to him own 40% of the shares. Oracle expects the deal to close this year and to boost earnings immediately. Now, naysayers would say it's pricey. The multiples more than Oracle has been spending on cloud buys lately. They'd also say Oracle already has similar cloud software to the business process products that NetSuite makes. But here's Oracle's justification. Oracle's recently gotten to the point where its cloud data center infrastructure is built out to the point where it can actually digest something like NetSuite, make money off of it. And the bulk of Oracle's business process customers are actually companies with more than 1,000 workers, and the bulk of NetSuite's are half that size. So what's clear here either way is that the hunt is on for cloud assets that the giants can gobble up to boost their growth. They're trying to surge ahead of others who are trying to catch up to them in the cloud, guys.
But given, you know, what you mentioned in terms of Larry Ellison's interest, is this anything like Elon Musk using Tesla to buy SolarCity?
Yeah, it is actually a lot like that for that exact same reason. So Oracle's going to have to thread the needle here. They've already said that the discussions around this, doing this, did not include Larry Ellison and the shares that need to be voted in order for this to go through. You know, Larry Ellison's controlled shares will not count toward that.
The nepotism aside, how many more companies are out there that can be gobbled up? I mean, where are we in the race to the cloud, as it were?
Well, you know, there are a few companies that play interestingly in this. Salesforce was a pioneer in the cloud, but it's at that size where it's too big for anybody to gobble easily, and it's big enough that it could gobble up some others. And then you've got the likes of Workday, which is run by the folks who used to run PeopleSoft before Oracle took it out. It is an interesting strategic asset. They're close to Salesforce philosophically. They're actually friends with Mark Benioff, but they've also been cozying up to Microsoft lately. Of course, Microsoft has his handful with LinkedIn now. So all of that makes this cloud space very interesting.